Well, you know, I say it a lot, but I mean it this time. I think it's working. Boy, oh boy. Guys, let's get caught up. We got a lot to catch up on, right? Are we here? Are we? You tell me. Are we here? Because while things look the same, everything between you and me has changed. Well, not everything, but a lot of things. Man, that was an unexpected hiatus, was it not? Yeah. Story time. Let's have a quick story time. So this is how things went down. 2 weeks ago, and now was it 3 weeks ago? No, 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago, the day before the live stream, I get a phone call from friend of the stream, Olivia Broadfield. She says, "Hey, I need your advice. It's time to update my computer, and you know my needs and the kind of music I make and the stuff I run, and you know computers well enough. So could you just give me some advice on what I need to get?" So I'm sitting on FaceTime with her, and we're going through Apple's website and talking about specs and things. And while we're talking, my screen goes blank. And I thought I had a power outage. It happens, old building. And so I go to turn the breaker, and I realize as I turn to go do that, I realize that everything else in my rack over here is still on. I was like, oh, I didn't have a power outage. Oh, I had a computer crash. Okay, let me restart. And I hit the start button on my computer, and it won't start. Oh, okay, I need to do like a hard reset sort of thing, you know, PMC reset and stuff. Nope. Okay, well, let me try some other things. Yada, yada, yada. My computer died. Like, died. I haven't had a computer, like, I've had computers get old and you go, oh, it's time to replace it. But I haven't had, like, one just, like, fry out like that. So, you know, I don't know what you guys think. I think Olivia broke my computer and she owes me a new computer. But so then, so that was, okay, so that's 2 weeks ago. And then, okay, we'll sort it out, get a new computer, get it set up. Everything's going to go okay, we think. And then funny thing happened, California caught on fire. Actually, the whole western U.S. caught on fire. And so I was sitting over here as things were getting literally smokier in my apartment. My breaking point was when I looked at my iPad and I had a layer of ash inside my apartment on my iPad. And I thought, you know what? I got to get out of here. So I headed east in search of clean air. I found clean air. What I didn't find was fast enough internet to actually talk to you guys. So I had all this stuff. I brought my mic. I brought my preamps. I brought my computer. I brought everything you could need to do a live stream, except the Hampton Inn's fabulous premium. I paid premium for that Wi-Fi or internet, I'll have you know. So anyway, guys, the point is we're back. Welcome back. It's just me today. So I'm just going to hang out with you guys while people are kind of coming in. And say the astute viewers may have noticed something up top there that during this interim, we have switched over from what was always just kind of a temporary name of this, because this was to some degree a temporary concept when it started, was Your Reason to Stay Inside. We've switched over to the new and improved Reason live stream. And you know, it reminded me of something. I'll tell this story briefly. So Scotland had this thing where they had a sign when you came into the Scotland airport, Edinburgh, I guess. I'll make that up. When you came into the Edinburgh airport, they had a big sign that welcomed you as you came down the escalator by baggage claim. And it said, "Scotland, small country, great land." Clever, cute, right? But they had that for like 20 years. And they're like, you know what? It's time to update the slogan. So they hired a consultancy agency, and that agency did workshops, and they brainstormed, and they brought in experts, and they came back to the whatever Scottish Tourism Board, and they presented their new slogan, and they had a, you know, slide presentation with a ton, all the reasoning that went into their thinking, and they had their focus group testing, and they had all this stuff winding it up to present them the new slogan. And then at the end, they showed this Photoshop mock-up of what it would look like with the new banner, and the new slogan read, "Welcome to Scotland." So in some ways, that's the discussion we sort of went through internally. We thought, you know, maybe it's time to rename it. And we thought, should we be super clever and come up with something kind of, you know, quirky? And then we thought, no, it is what it is. Let's call it what it is. It's sort of like the way players work in Reason. It's like the scales and chords player tells you what it does. It does scales and chords. The dual arpeggio is a dual arpeggio player. And so the Reason Livestream, that's what it is. It's a Reason Livestream. So that's what we went with. And that's, I guess, what we'll be going with going forward. Shout out to Matilda. She did a new graphic for me, and I kind of love, here, I'm going to switch over to it just to shout her out here. She did this cool little thing with the, like, I just love the little beams of the Reason logo emanating. It's, you know, if I were playing Pictionary and I needed to say Reason Livestream, that's what I would draw. So anyway, how's everybody doing? How have you been? I hope that you have been making music while I have been away. I'm seeing a couple of things in here. The requisite banjo jokes are going on there. Yeah, be careful. Hampton Inn is a Reason sponsor. That's right. We don't want to, you know, mess with that very lucrative Hampton Inn dollar. You know what I got to say? Maybe I will gripe a little bit for a second. So I was there for 3 days. The first 2 days I paid for premium internet. I did a speed test and it was miserable. And then the third day I thought, well, I'm not going to pay for the premium internet for the third day. And I did a speed test. Same speed. Free internet, premium internet, same speed. It's like when Chicago's Wrigley Field, somebody did a video where they poured a small beer into the cup for a large beer. And you realize that they were just shaped a little more conically so that the large looked like it held more, but it actually held the same exact volume. That's the Hampton Inn's little premium internet scam. Same speed. Anyway. So, yeah, but I hope you guys have made some music while I've been gone. I've made some music. I'll fill in a little bit of what I've been up to, or I guess the project I made right before I evacuated. My brother, who's a guest on this stream, he's working on a game. I'm not a video gamer, but it's a game big enough that even I know the title, but I can't say it because that's the way those projects kind of go. But he called me up. He needed some guitar. And so I was like literally like booking my rental car to get out of town and my hotel and planning my escape and looking at air quality monitors while simultaneously renting a Rickenbacker 12-string, electric 12-string, and then layering up a bunch of guitars for him all in the same day, you know, and sending him stems and going, is it good? It works? Okay, I'm out of here. And then I took off. So, Mein Vague, Al's producer. Why no orange mug? It's a good point. They don't make this mug in orange. If they did, you know, it's a good point, though. I might take that under advisement. And maybe we'll switch up to a orange mug. We'll have to see. Some colleagues I work with and have, you know, we all live on Zoom calls now. And so people have caught on to that yellow mug and it's become something of a fun thing when it makes an appearance on a Zoom call. Guys, okay, should we talk about the subject at hand? Because we have a lot to cover here. And I figured we'll just kind of get to it. I'm sort of hating myself for having come up with the idea of doing harmony, of me doing a harmony workshop with you guys, because once I started preparing for it, I started thinking, that means I gotta sing for the next hour and whatever minutes, I'm going to be singing for you guys. And let me tell you, that's not a thing anybody loves, I don't think. But what happened with the... with this stream topic. This stream topic came up from a chat that happened in a comment that happened in the chat. It was the stream we had DJ Khalil. He was having a little technical problem, so I was just kind of hanging out with you guys beforehand. And somebody just in the chat said, "How do you sing vocal harmony? How do you learn to sing vocal harmony on the fly?" And I thought, "Ooh, boy, that's a complicated." It's a simple topic that can be complicated if you don't know the method. And then it's a skill that needs to be developed. The on the fly part is not, it's not quite, you know, there's not a thing I certainly couldn't have typed in the chat. Oh, you just, you know, shmurble your mind up a third and then you're going to be singing on the fly. And they go, oh, okay, I got it. I don't know what verb that is to schmerble. But anyway, my point is it's a thing that sort of warranted its own topic, its own day. And so I thought, you know what? I'm going to actually prepare for it and show you guys in more detail than just what I could possibly do while we were waiting on Khalil to get on the stream or while we were, while we're chatting. So yeah, I'll keep my eye on the chat while we're going here, and then we're going to get to some stuff. I'm seeing talk of, is my mom in the chat? Is she there? Mm-hmm. She might be. She watches sometimes. It happens. It's funny. I get text messages from people that watch that I don't realize are watching. You know, some of you guys that just know my number, not everybody knows my number. Then some other people, and then I'll just get these text messages. Sometimes during the stream, they can be a little bit distracting. But then also after the stream, there's a trend I've noticed that, some of you people like to call me and have like a post stream wrap up show just with me. So, I've started being more selective in, that not occupying the rest of my afternoon. But anyway, okay, we're going to talk about harmony. And in order to do that, I've actually prepared some slides because there's a lot of visual in the beginning. And the idea is that once we understand kind of, I guess, visually, but aurally, sonically, what is happening, we can move over to putting it into practice. And then over time, people who want to do this on the fly, it will start to happen on the fly for you. I am not great at this. So let me put this up front. I think I even said on the last stream, this is sort of the most recent major musical skill I have acquired. If I went back 2 years, 3 years maybe, 2 years. If I go back in time a little bit, this was just alchemy to me. It was a mystery how people were able to just have a melody and then just start singing a harmony on top of it. And I know arrangement, I know harmony, and I know, you know, theory to some degree, but I struggled with doing it kind of intuitively. And what I ended up, it was something I really wanted to learn, especially, you know, in my world that I, with the acoustic sort of roots Americana music that I do, it's a pretty important thing to be able to do. And I used to have to, you know, if there was a song and I wanted to sing harmony on it, I would sit at home for an entire evening and I would just like be plotting it out, you know, like a string arranger, you know, like working out the parts. And then I'd show up and then, you know, someone might sing it with a slightly different melody and suddenly all my work was out the window. And I thought, God damn it. So I really wanted to learn it. And I ended up taking a workshop which for the sake of it, I'll just shout out the two people that ran the workshop. It was a songwriter, a musician named Joe Newberry, and Val Mindel, who is a singer and artist in her own right. And they ran this workshop up in Portland, and I had taken a class with Val before, and I just thought if she ever comes within a 500 or 1,000-mile radius of San Francisco again, I'm going to take a class. And so I went up there and I took a weekend workshop with them. And because I had been doing some of the work beforehand, that weekend flicked the switches for me, and it all made sense and it clicked and I got it. And from then on, I've been able to, maybe not on the fly perfectly, but I understand what I'm going for and I can work out harmonies quicker. And what I'm going to show you today is some of the work that I was figuring out and learning beforehand, and then some of the sort of switches that flipped for me when I was working with them in their workshop. So, let's get to it. I'm going to bring up some slides. Look at this. Da-da! How's that going? Let me just, while everyone marvels at the amazing graphic, I'm just going to see what else is going on here. People talking about whether they sing or not. Oh, I was going to say, here's the thing. If, let's say you're watching the stream right now and you're like, I don't sing, I don't want to sing. How does this relate to me? And let me give you my pitch, my stay tuned pitch. There's a two-part stay tuned pitch to this. Number one is if you're a producer and you work with a vocalist, you want to be able to work with them and not just go like, could you do a harmony? And then when they do something, go like, I guess that's right. Like you want to sort of have some knowledge yourself so that you can just be a good collaborative partner. with a vocalist, even if you're not the one singing. And part two, and I didn't fully think of this until recently, is that what I'm teaching you is not how to sing harmony. I'm teaching you how to arrange harmony. I've taken the word sing out of it because the same rules that I'm going to show you, if you wanted to make a string arrangement with friction, let's say you had a friction string melody that you wrote and you wanted to turn that into an arrangement that has, you know, some strings above it and some strings below it. Same rules apply. We're not writing the rules for vocal harmony singing. We're writing the rules for harmony arranging, and that will apply all over to what you do. So, So with that in mind, let's start talking about this a little bit. All right. Reason now supports PowerPoint. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So, actually this isn't PowerPoint, but that's okay. I made it in PowerPoint. Okay. So let's talk about this. We're going to talk about harmony singing today. Gotta move over here. In order to do that, let's talk about harmony singing as we know it, its origin. I'm not going to make this a long history lesson, but this is kind of worth knowing. Harmony singing as we know it came from the churches, and it came from sort of the things that monks were doing. They used to sing in unison, and then they started singing in fifths, and then they started figuring out what is our sort of 12-tone Western music system as we know it. And they came up with some rules for harmony that you can hear in Bach etudes and these sort of things. But as we know harmony singing in pop music, it is that church origin fused with a mountain music tradition, which is why I kind of love it, because it like falls right into my world in that sense. It's my interest. It's kind of these two interests of classic music production and theory mixed with this sort of just mountain tradition. And so what was happening is people were living in the mountains of Virginia and North Carolina, the Appalachian region. They were going to church. They were singing gospel church songs. They were learning all these songs. Then they were going home, and in the evenings and the weekends, you know, they were getting together. They were playing music. They were writing a lot of the songs that were adapted from songs that came over from sort of German and Irish immigrants, but also fused with some of the spirituals that were coming from the plantation tradition. And all of this was kind of getting mixed up, and they were layering these harmonies using the rules they had learned from their church tradition. And so the classic example is the Carter family. Carter family harmonies. These guys, I know they don't look super cool, but let me tell you, these guys were, this is like Billie Eilish and Beyonce and Harry Styles of 1927. These guys were a pop sensation. And the reason they were is because recorded music at the time classical music. It was people in New York that were recording classical music and putting out these 78 RPM albums. They were called albums because they literally had like five discs in them. They came in a bound album. And people were listening to them, and they were fine. It was nice to have music at home to listen to. But sales were starting to wane a little bit, and the New York record companies were starting to wonder why their product wasn't resonating now that the novelty of listening at home had worn off. And so they sent some people out to figure it out. And one of these guys went to Bristol, Virginia, and he put out an ad in the paper, and he said, I want to record sort of pop, it wasn't called pop music, but I want to record sort of the songs, your local songs. Bring me your local songs. One of the people that came were the Carter family, and they did exactly that thing of singing their local songs using the church sort of harmony rules. And so here, I'm going to play a little bit of one of those recordings. This was the first recording. This is referred to as the Big Bang of pop music because it was the first sort of non-just classical hoity-toity type songs. Take a listen. All right. Now, believe it or not, as weird as that sounds, you know, it sounds like when you watch an old black and white movie, it's like the sonic equivalent of an old black and white movie, and it may not resonate with you in any way on a musical level. But what they're doing in that song, the way that they've arranged their harmonies is the exact same way that, you know, if tomorrow there's a session where Justin Timberlake's working on his next album and they want to layer some harmonies, they're going to do Exactly the same thing. Exactly the same thing. And so I think it's so neat that that it just kind of works and we can sort of follow their same thing. So I'm looking at some comments. I'm kind of trying to watch comments at the same time here. Trying to work out harmonies makes my brain melt. Let's fix that. Let's make that not the case anymore. Okay, so that is sort of the origin of where it comes from. It's worth mentioning that there are kind of two different basic categories of harmony singing. One is duet singing. The other one is what we might call harmony stacks, or what I'm going to call harmony stacks. Now, duet singing, I'm not going to teach you how to write harmony duets. And why am I not going to teach you that? Because anything goes. If you're one person singing with another person, if it sounds good, it's good. And a lot of people that do duet singing will adapt. What they're really doing is they're actually following the rule of harmony stack singing, and then they're breaking the rule a lot because they have the ability to, because they don't have to worry about it. You'll see as we go through this that once you introduce a third part into harmony, suddenly you have to be very mindful of where the melody's at, where the other harmony's at, and where you fit into that. You don't want to step on anyone's toes. But in a duet world, as long as you're not singing the same thing that the other person singing, then it's fair game. And so duet singing, we're not going to cover that in this because it is much more of a loosey-goosey type thing. But harmony singing is, like I said, it's the discipline is crucial, and it's a more rigid sort of rule set that we can talk about. So let's talk about those rules. Rule number one, don't double notes. This is like, well, I guess I have to say this. Every rule is like, don't do this unless you want to do it. I mean, you can. Like, no one's going to revoke your Reason license because you did this or something. You know, you're not gonna get kicked off Spotify for doubling notes. But what do I mean by this? What I mean is that by its very nature, in order to sing harmony, you need to be singing a different note than the other person or other persons. So the game of harmony is to, the melody is what the melody is. You're adding a harmony to the melody. And as the melody moves, you need to move to stay out of the way of the melody, right? And so here, I'm going to do some weird visuals here for a second. I know I said we weren't going to talk about duets, but wait, let me do this. If the melody is going up, we need to go up to stay away from it, because otherwise, if not, it would come up and we would sing the same note. We'd be breaking rule number one. So we have to kind of move. If the melody goes down, we can move down. We could let the melody go down and then stay. Or in a duet world, this is where duets get a little weirder. We can hopscotch the melody. So if the melody is, you know, kind of going up, we could go underneath, and then we could, you know, we could be kind of ducking and weaving above it. This will make sense as we go. But the key thing to know right now, rule number one, don't double notes. And you're going to hear me today making sure throughout the entire process that I'm not doubling notes. So, rule number two, be melody adjacent. That's kind of a simple one, and yet not. What we're trying to do is we're trying to move in concert with whatever the melody is. We want to be near the melody, adjacent to the melody, not on the melody, and not so far away that our harmony, you know, if you start getting into bigger harmony distances, the sort of the quality of harmony, the close sympathetic harmonic resonance that when two notes that are, you know, share commonalities in the harmonic series, I mean, that's what makes harmony kind of feel buzzy and nice. As you move further apart, those relationships get more farther apart. And so they tend to feel less harmonic, as it were. So we want to be close to the melody, but not on it, just adjacent to it. Rule number two. Rule number three, stay in the chord. We have notes in the chord that we're playing. This, I got to say, this was actually maybe the biggest thing I was doing wrong for the longest time. And I'll show you. We're gonna go through. We're gonna do some examples. But I did this all the time. What I was trying to do was I was trying to stay. I understood. I had the part where I was like, oh, I'm gonna stay note adjacent. I had rule number one: don't double the note I'd rule number two, stay nearby but not but adjacent to the note. Rule number three, I would often, I sort of had this basic comp, like, oh yeah, harmonies, it's like you're a third away, right? Like you're a third away, and then if you want to add another harmony, maybe that's a fifth away from your note. And so I would write these harmonies that, do I have, no, I don't have a piano going here yet. Let me see if I can easily put a piano up for you a second. I would, so I'd write these harmonies that if the melody goes, I would write a harmony that goes. And you know what happens when you do that? You're playing chopsticks. You're arranging the melodic version of chopsticks. And that's not cool. It doesn't sound good. And it doesn't sound like the things that we hear when we listen to records that have harmony. And so I would write these things where I'd be like writing sort of these parallel thirds to the melody notes. And I'd be like, it's in the key. I know it's in the scale. What am I doing wrong? And suddenly, once I learned the stay in the chord rule number three, it was like the final piece that clicked in where I was like, oh, so there's a little more to it. And I'll show you what I mean. But that's it. Those are the three rules. Don't double notes. Stay note adjacent. Stay in the chord. Bob is your uncle. I see. Giles Reeves is going to be, okay. Giles. Okay. Giles is in the comments saying, I disagree with the stay in the chord. Love it when a harmony sings a minor over a major third or vice versa. Okay. Now listen, Giles, let's you and I have a little side talk here for a second. Yes. Advanced harmony, complex harmonic tones, sevenths, compound harmonies, suspensions, fourths and sus twos and all that sort of stuff. You're totally not wrong. But for teaching harmony, it's like, you know, what you're sort of talking about is like someone who wants to learn to ride a bike, and someone goes like, I love jumping off ramps and you know, sliding down rails. I'm like, yeah, you'll get there, but first we're gonna learn to pedal, and we're gonna learn to not fall over. So yes, and it's like I said with all these things up top, these are the rules until they're not, until you want to do something else. And if it sounds good, it is good. There is some element to that. So, but if you know these rules, the reason you, I mean, even in your comment, Giles, what you're saying is, you love when a harmony singer is singing a minor third over a major third. What you're demonstrating is that you know the rule and you like breaking the rule. And that's a totally valid thing too. So if people learn the rules and can do it and then understand what their own taste is in terms of breaking it, great. But I will say, Giles, then you might find the rest of this entire thing very frustrating if you're looking for the outside the box stuff. We're going to be doing the fundamentals of harmony. Okay. no need to apologize, Giles. I think it's a worthwhile viewpoint to bring up. So I appreciate you bringing it up. But I do think there are people, you know, we on these live streams, we cater to people at all levels, and so I do want people to understand that there is, yeah, it's a spectrum. It's like everything in music. It's just like, you know, if we were literally sticking to all the rules that we ever had, I mean, you know, talk about the church organ origins I was talking about of harmony. If we stuck to the rule originally when monks were singing was you sing in unison, harmony wouldn't exist. They would just still be singing, you know, Domine est Domino, whatever, you know, Latin. So breaking rules, good, but learning the rules so you can break them, even better. Okay, so let's go through with some visuals here. Oh, yeah. So I want to, this is something I'm going to teach you, the nomenclature that I have learned, the terms that I've learned. And if you come from or if you're familiar with sort of choir singing, this is going to break your brain for a little bit. It did mine, but you'll get used to this pretty quickly. There are terms that are used in vocal arranging that are, they borrow from terms that are used in choral arranging, but it's different. So for example, if I'm singing the melody, if I'm talking to someone who's familiar with these terms, and I would say that the person singing the melody is singing the lead. Okay, that's simple enough. So far, we're okay. Person singing the melody, singing the lead. You could also call it the melody. No one's gonna complain. The harmony, which is one chord interval above the melody, is what's referred to as the tenor part. Now, if anyone knows soprano, alto, tenor, bass in choral singing, tenor would refer to a certain range of the male, the sort of the upper range of the male vocal range, and then alto is kind of the lower range of the female, and soprano is the upper range of the female, etc. Throw that out. That is not this. And you'll see, because these start breaking their definitions in terms of this. So the tenor part is the part one, I'm going one chord degree above the melody. Then the next one, if I'm going one chord degree below the melody, I'm going baritone. That would be called the baritone part. Now, that so far kind of makes sense. Where it gets weirder is when you aren't doing this type of arrangement. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so we've got we got some piano keys here, and we got a chord. Here's our C major chord. And for the sake of this illustration, my melody note on a C major chord that I'm going to be singing is going to be the middle note. So I've got all these, those are the three chords of a C major chord, and I'm singing the middle one. If I'm arranging the harmony, if I want to sing a harmony note to that lead note, my choices are going to be one of those three notes, one of those three blue notes. So we can rule one out right away, right? Which one, what is not going to be my harmony note? It's going to be that note. Why? Because rule number one, don't double notes. If I'm singing that note against my lead singer, then I'm just singing unison. That's not harmony. So what are my other choices? It's one of those two. If that's my note and I go to the higher chord degree like that, that would be my tenor part. If I go to the lower chord degree, that would be my baritone part. Got it? So far? I'll periodically just kind of check in with the chat to see that this is making sense. And when we start doing it in practice, some more of this will keep making sense. But Ivan, what are we talking about today? Just getting here late. Sorry for the arrival. We're talking about harmony. And you haven't missed the nuts and bolts, so you're all good. What about a whole octave is a question? A whole octave would be considered a unison. Basically, it's not really, you're not actually, it's not a harmony. It's basically a unison. Okay, so to extend this concept, we want to find the notes of the harmonies for our C major chord. If we're arranging a harmony, here's the one that we did. We're putting a lead in the middle, right? So I'm playing a C major chord. If I'm singing this note, that's too high. There we go. If I'm singing that note and I want to put a harmony on it, I need to find my notes elsewhere in the chord. This one or this one. Now, let me give you a tip. Hang on. Let's see if we... Here's the thing with this harmony. I'm going to be doing a lot of guitar plunking today more than piano plunking, but the greatest gift you could give yourself in learning to do this stuff is some ear training. And so, for example, let me just go to C since we're talking about C. No, I won't because it's a little high. I'm going to stay where I was. We'll do it in A. If I'm trying to find the harmony note for any tone in the scale, I need to become comfortable with the tones. Oh, sorry, tone in the chord. I need to be comfortable with the tones of the chord. And for our sake today, we're going to be talking about triads, standard triads. That means that the chord is going to have the one, the root of the chord, the third scale degree, and the fifth, 1, 3, and 5. That's how most chords, most triads are built up that way. And so something we can do to get really comfortable with finding these notes is getting comfortable at singing those doing the ear training to sing those intervals. So this is something I started out doing, is I'd play a chord. Dum dum dum, okay. Dum dum dum, dum 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 dum. I'll try to move that up. Dum 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 dum. I practiced just getting comfortable with those, and if that's you can do it just by. You can play them and sing along with them, and then you can eventually just vamp a chord. Dum, 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 dum. And those notes, I'm going to give you guys a couple of ways to kind of get used to finding those, get comfortable finding those. Dum, 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 dum is a great song, Beat Boy. Here's a couple of, we know these scale or chord intervals pretty well from certain things in pop culture. So for example, this is going to be an old reference, but does anyone remember the Three Stooges? Three Stooges would pop their heads around a corner and they go, hello, 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 right? They would stack a little harmony there. Hello, hello, hello. Those are the intervals of the chord. That's, I mean, that in my version I'm singing here, I'm starting on the five. Five, one, three. Hello, hello, hello. But I could start, hello, hello, hello. That's the same thing. Or here's another one that uses the scale degrees. This one starts on the one, so it might help people. Remember Twist and Shout? You can do that that harmony stack. Don't worry about that fourth one. That's the Giles interval. But anyway, the first three. That's one, three, five. That's your intervals. In fact, here's another one. People in the U.S., NBC, the NBC jingle. That's one, five, three. How about a doorbell? If you know, what sound does a doorbell make? Bing bong, bing bing bong. That's one, and then it's going down to what is the fifth note of the fifth of the chord. Bong, bong. Or if you start it on a different tone, bong, make the doorbell sound. Bong, 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 bong. Like anytime you do a doorbell using the notes of a major chord, you're singing the 1-3-5 intervals. So it's worth mentioning because we're going to be, as I'm doing harmonies, I'm going to be constantly trying to find those intervals. I'm going to have a note. I'm going to be going, what's one chord interval away? And I'm going to be doing that sort of practice over and over and over again. So, yes. Okay. So this is a, if we have the lead in the middle, this is kind of how that chord might stack up. What if we didn't want our lead to be in the middle? So if we didn't want our lead to be in the middle, let's put it on the bottom. That's the note that our singer is singing, and we want to put two harmony parts above our lead vocalist. The first one that goes above, so let's follow our rules. Rule number one, don't double the note. Okay, well that means I can't sing the same note that the singer is singing. Rule number two, be note adjacent. Okay, so I want to be the next scale interval, or I want to be the next note away, the closest note that I can be away, but above the lead. And rule number three, stay in the chord. So if I do that, I have only one choice, and that is to be, remember, this was my chord, and so my tenor, I'm going to use these terms so we get used to them, my tenor harmony that is one scale, one chord interval above my lead is going to be that G. Now, what if I want to put a harmony above rather than below? When I went this way, I put a harmony below. But this now I want to put a harmony above. So what happens if I want to move this harmony above? Do I do this? I'm going to ask in the see what people say in the comments. I will say this is what I used to do. This was my old sort of thinking that wasn't getting me the results that I liked. Because I would look at that and go, okay, like this one is it's a third below the lead. And so now I want to put another one above the harmony. I put a third above that. And why does it sound not quite right? The answer is, Mark says no. Mark is correct. That is not what we want to go with. Because what did we do? What did we get wrong? We broke rule number three. We didn't stay in the chord. This note that we were singing beneath the lead was a C. And now we've gone to a B. So that is not correct. If we want to stay in the chord, this is what our harmony stack would look like when we have one note, then a note above, and then, oh wait, sorry. That's our lead. One note above, and then a note above that. Okay? That's how that works. Now, this is where the brain starts to break in terms of, remember I was saying that the naming of these things gets weird? The blue one, it's one above the one chord degree away from the lead. One chord degree away from the lead going up is called the tenor. Then if you go one above that, you know what it's called? It's called high baritone, which, like, if you came from a choir like I did, high baritone makes no sense. That's like bass soprano. It's like, what are you talking about? But that's what it's called in a lot of harmony arranging, high baritone. And the reason it's called high baritone is because it's a high part, but it's actually singing, if I go back, it's singing the same note as what we were calling the baritone here. So it's you'll notice that if you were to work out a high baritone part and a baritone part that is just one below a melody, they're actually going to be the same notes. So you can call them high baritone. You can call that low baritone. You can call, low tenor. We'll get there. Okay. So, So what we've got here though, is we've got that choice by deciding which way we do our harmony stack. We can decide whether we want to put the lead on the bottom and stack above it, or we want to put the lead in the middle and stack below it, or whether we want to put the lead on the top. So let's do the lead on the top together. Why not recording chords on piano and just singing into separate chord notes? Not sure what you mean, but if you can explain it, I will answer it. Paco, how does this work in modern pop music where the harmony and the melody are independent? Paco, they're not. Unless they are. Okay. This is the weird. So when we're talking about fundamentals, 90% of harmony arranging in pop, modern pop music is following these rules. And you'll see, and we're going to actually do an example that uses a very pop song, and we're going to put some harmony on it, and you'll see what I mean. But they aren't independent. And the only reason they would be independent is if you're going for a particular style that you've decided to break the rules. You've consciously decided to break the rules. So, okay, let's talk about this example. We're singing that C major chord, we're singing that E, and we're going to sing da-da-da, and I want to put two harmonies beneath that. So, how can I find the lower harmony? So I can find the lower harmony two ways. I can stare at my keyboard and look at the notes of my chord and realize that it's going to only be one of two notes. Or I can doorbell it. When I'm going below, dung, 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 make a doorbell sound, ding, dong, dong. Congratulations, you've just sung the baritone part to this note. Bong, bong, right? Bong, bong. Now, so let me advance my slide. There you go. Baritone part. Bong. If we want to put the part below that, what do we do? Yohani, he says, ding dong. He correct. Yohani, that is what we're going to do. I'm going to ding dong my way down to the next note. Again, so I don't need to think about this on a keyboard level. I can think about it. And this is the on the fly part. This is the thing that you develop over time, the more you do this. And once the switches start to flip, you'll start doing it pretty quickly. It's not that That tough Stefan says, come in. Yeah. So we've got, this is our melody note, dong, and we got bing bong. So now we got this note, dong. Now how does the doorbell go? Bong bong, right? Ding dong. There you go. There's our notes. So our melody, lead, bang ding dong, 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 dong. It's that easy. At least if we're if we're singing a song called Ding Dong, and if we are only singing on one chord. So I think here's all of our options on that C major chord spread out on the keyboard. I think it's time maybe to take a look at ever increasing sort of real world examples maybe. So why don't we do that? Is that the end of my slides? Let me make sure. Yeah, that is the end of my slides. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to jump over to Reason, and I'm going to grab my guitar, and we're going to start doing some harmony and actual singing. And let me tell you, who was the guy that came up with the idea where he had to sing for you guys for a long time? I don't know. I want to talk to that guy. I think his name's Ryan, but be kind to me, guys. I'm going to be singing a lot for you today, and I don't really fancy myself much of a singer per se, but I have a sense of pitch, so someone had to volunteer for the job, and that's me. Okay, so here's what I got. I've got I got to switch over to Reason. Let's see. We're going to go here. We're going to jump here. Okay, so I've recorded. I spared us the time of me actually recording the guitar, and I just recorded a chord progression. And the chord progression is very basic. I mean, I'm starting us very much in the tradition of that Carter family tradition of just, you know, very basic 1-4-5. If you watched the live stream we did on chord progressions, we're going to do a very basic chord progression, and we're going to sing a very basic melody, and then we're going to add a fundamental harmony stack on top of that basic melody. And so here's the chord progression. Right. Okay. Simple enough. If I wanted to put a melody on that, most melodies, again, like I should probably stop throwing this preface on there, but I want to make sure that people who are tuning in late and want to jump in with comments where they go, well, that's not always the case, are aware that we're talking fundamental rules, and so we're going to speak fundamentally. So fundamentally speaking, our melodies that we sing over top of these chords are usually coming from notes that are in the chords. So if I were to sing a note, like a melody, I might pick da 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 da, and then when I change chords, I have choices. I could da da da, or I could go da da, or go da da. Right? These are just all the notes in the chords. Da 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 da. Like that would be. It's not a great melody, but that would be a sort of acceptable melody that you could write over these chords. So let me put down, I'm going to just sing absolute throwaway lyrics on this, but I'm going to try and sing, by and large, I'm going to try and stick to singing tones that are in the chord. So this could turn into the Bing Bong song. No, that's, I don't think anyone needs that. So let's, here, I'm just going to sing any old thing. Let's give it a go. Hopefully, Hopefully I can do this with you guys all watching. Don't look. Okay, here, watch. Don't watch me. Here we go.
Harmony. We sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. You,
Wait. Chord changed and I didn't go with it. I'm going to punch in. Actually, I'll back this up just a little bit.
We sing harmony. Sing harmony.
Okay, we're gonna call that an absolutely Grammy winning performance, and I'm just gonna join those together now. For the sake of our work today, I'm gonna be a little bit more liberal with my use of pitch edit, because I don't want to have to do a bunch of takes until I get my intonation spot on for you guys. So I'm just going to do a little correction. Let's play it back. Oh, we can pull that out. That's me just finding my note. Not a bad thing to do if you're a singer. Don't worry about, you know, finding your note before the song and then trimming.
Harmony. We sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. You and me sing harmony.
It's a hit, guys. Let me tell you, it's a total hit. Okay, so I moved it down to a track that has reverb so that I can live with myself vaguely. Thank you for those that are being kind to me in the comments. Thank you. Because it's like, if you don't like my singing right now, you got a lot more of it. So here we go. I did put some reverb on it. I didn't put pulverizer, you honey, but we're going to just go with some reverb. Okay. Now there we go. That's our song. Our singer has come to us in our little session here and they say, and I want to put harmony on this, or maybe you're the songwriter and you want to put harmony on it. And, let's go ahead and figure that out. And in order to do that, we're going to start using some real world examples here. First thing I need to understand is, what are my melody notes, right? I am flexed. Take my money. That's right. That's going to be dropping on Spotify after this stream. It's going to be amazing. Okay. Now, my first chord, my first note that I'm singing, let's find it.
Harmony.
That's what it is.
Harmony. Harmony.
Okay. Now I want to add a harmony note above that lead tone. And I'll tell you now, that's an A. That's the one of the chord, the tonic of the chord, the root of the chord, whatever you want to call it. That's the one. Let's follow our rules. Now I've got three choices. I can sing the one, the three, or the five. What is rule number one? It's don't double the notes. I'm singing the one. What can't I sing? I can't sing the one. Okay. Rule number two, be note adjacent. Okay, well, if I'm singing the one and I want to be the next scale chord tone above the one to sing a harmony above, I have one choice, only one choice, and that is the three. Da, da, and remember these, ba, 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 the old, the Beatles, ba, ba, that's my note. So if my melody is singing
harmony,
then that means I'm gonna have to make sure that I'm not clipping on you guys as we do this. So let me know in the comments if I start clipping, and I'll make some adjustments to my, I'll ride my levels as we go here. Okay, so if my note, so I'm harmony, am I ba-da, harmony, here's what happens.
Harmony, we sing.
Look at that, guys. Look what happened. All we did is follow our rules and pa-bong, we're singing harmony. Right? So, now, let's do it again because it's fun to sing harmony.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Uh-oh, things went weird. Wait, hang on.
We sing harmony.
Did you hear that? That's kind of a not quite right harmony. Why is that happening? What's happening? What's going on there? Well, let's take a look. What happens is if I mute this vocal, let's just listen to the underlying harmonic structure. Ah! The chord changed. Now, what happens when the chord changes? When the chord changes, our rules don't change, but we need to follow our rules. And so the note choices that we're making no longer apply. Here's what I mean. Watch this. So,
harmony, harmony.
The melody here goes like this.
We sing har.
Now, what is the melody doing? It's staying the same.
We sing har.
It doesn't change the note.
We sing har.
But the chord underneath changes.
We sing har.
Right? And so, my harmony note.
We sing har. We sing.
Now I need to find, let's throw out what we've done so far and just think about just the word, the syllable I'm singing there is harm, and the note I'm singing is that.
Harm.
Now, is this, that's an A on a D and a D chord. Is it an A? Yes. Is it a D chord? Yes. Okay, just double checking I've got a capo on my guitar, so. I'm keeping my eye on the comments. You guys are making me laugh. Okay, so let's follow our rules. We're singing this note on this chord. We want to sing. Do we want to sing that note? No, that breaks rule number one. We want to sing the next chord tone above the note we have.
Dum, dum.
And so let's do it using our vocal tools.
Bum.
Can we sing the 1-3-5? Can you guys? You guys should be. I should say this. You guys should be singing at home. So do this with me. I hope you're doing this with me. I'm going to sing. I just want to sing that, you know, the like when we did with this one.
Ba, 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 ba.
I'm going to do that same thing on this new chord to get comfortable with the intervals of that chord. So
ba, 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 bum, 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 bum.
So those are the tones of the four chord, which is the chord that we're using in this progression. Which yes, someone I'm seeing it's 5-1-3. That's the way that because I'm singing that
we harmony we sing harm.
That's the fifth of that chord. So okay, so don't worry about that. So but let's just do this with our brains and our instincts, right? So.
Dung.
So if our tones are bung, 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 and we're singing this harm, what is our harmony note above that?
Bung, 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 sorry, dung,
So
harmony.
Let me just cue that part up for a second and show you just the word harm.
Harm, harm, harm.
Right? Now here we were singing a different note.
Harmony, we sing.
But that note doesn't work here. But
harm, harm,
that note works. So what are we doing? Let's actually plunk it on a guitar for a second. What I'm doing is I'm saying
harmony, we sing harmony.
I'm going up just one note to fit in the chord.
Harmony.
Okay? That just... All that did was solve one syllable, harm.
Harmony.
But now look, oh geez, the singer had the audacity to change the melody note. So we got to do it all over again. But that's okay. It gets faster and faster as we do it. We get more instinctual with it as we do it. So let's back up and just get to that part.
Harmony, we sing harm.
Okay, cool, good. Now, let's figure out this note. What is the melody doing? That's what I need to answer at all times. What is the lead doing?
Harmony.
Okay. Harm. Now, the lead is, when I wrote this melody, I wrote a melody that is moving through chord tones. So it goes,
harmony.
That's still in the chord.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Mark says this song needs a parental advisory, explicit content warning. Absolutely. Wait till you hear the bars that I'm going to have someone drop on it. It's going to be just murderous and explicit in all ways. No. So
the melody's going harmony.
So it moved down.
Harmony.
Now, what happens? So, well, actually, let me keep my guitar for a second. What is our choice? Well, if we wanted to stay in the chord, we're singing here.
Harmony, harmony.
Could I sing this note, harmony, and stay on it?
We sing harmony.
Could I do that? Let's try it.
We sing harmony.
I mean, it sounds okay. It sounds okay. Let's review our rules, though, because we're creating disciplined harmony stacks. So what are our rules? Is this note and this note the same note? That would be rule number one, don't double notes. It does not. It qualifies for rule number one. Does it qualify for rule number three? Are they tones within the chord? Yes, they are. Okay, we pass rule number three. Is it lead adjacent or melody adjacent? Is it the nearest note interval between the melody and the harmony? The answer on that one? No. There's a note in between because my melody went harmony, went down harmony. It went down, and so now we need to move down with it, and we move down not in parallel. This is where I went wrong early on in my musical journey. We move down in the chord. We move to the next chord because this one moved one chord interval down.
Da, harmony.
We can move this one down.
Harmony.
These are the same. Da, 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 da. That's just 1-3-5. So we're going to
harmony. That's our melody.
And I can move in chordal parallel.
Harmony, harmony.
Okay. Let's see how that feels.
In harmony, in harmony.
Let's back up.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Do you hear how that, when I move down with it, we create that kind of buzzy sound. That buzzy sound keeps going. Whereas if I stayed on that note,
we sing harmony.
Do you hear how they start to move apart? It's like the two voices are pulling away from each other. And when they pull away, we lose some of the harmonic fuzz that is going on. I mean, it really is, you know, the same thing of what does a fuzz pedal do on a guitar? It introduces harmonic distortion and harmonic, complementary harmonics. I mean, it's the same thing. So we're going to stay close together.
We sing harmony.
Okay, let's put that down real quick. Here, I'm going to do a dub. Let me know if this is making sense and going okay for you guys in the comments. If people are following along and if this is somewhat new to you having a method like this, then let me know how it's working for you. Let's put this one down.
Harmony.
Really? Do it again.
Harmony. We sing harmony.
Good enough for rock and roll. Okay, I'm going to just jump in here. And again, I'm just going to be a little bit more rigid on the pitch edit than I normally would be in life.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Great, right? Okay, now let's move on.
Harmony.
Oh, Okay, what's happening there? Okay, well, first thing's happening. Let's listen. Let's take away the melody for a second and listen just to the chord. Whoops, sorry. Okay, so if you listen to the chord there, it's going back to the first chord. It's starting here. Then we go to a higher chord. Then we go back. Okay, so we're going back to our first chord, which is our one chord, which is an A. And what is our melody doing?
Harmony.
Harm. Okay, so it's the first note that we did. Harm, harm. And we already know the melody, the harmony for that.
Harm.
But then the note goes up. What does the melody do? It goes.
Harmony. Harmony.
Ah, okay. We're singing this note. Melody is singing this note. Da, 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 da. Then what happens is the melody encroaches on the note. It steps into our territory.
Harmony.
All of a sudden, our harmony. If we stayed there, if I just did that.
Harmony.
Do you hear that? You hear it goes to unison?
Harmony.
And suddenly when it does, it just gets like, it sounds like a double vocal because it is a double vocal. I'm singing the same syllables and the same note. So I'm breaking rule number one, can't break rule number one. So we got to find a new note. So how do we find a new note? Well, if that melody has moved into our territory, we have to move out of its way. And so we move out of its way by finding what? We find the next chord interval above that note. So,
dum, dum,
let's sing our 1-3-5s. Everyone do it with me.
Bum, 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 ba-da-dum. There's our note. Bum, 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 bum.
Same old, if you want to use your Beatles trick.
Doom, dum, dum.
I can't not do that. Anyway, okay. Da-da-da-da-da-da. So that's our note. So we need to move up. Okay, so let's do that.
Harmony.
There it is.
Harmony.
Perfect. Following all our rules. Bob is your uncle. I've used that already today. Today's show is brought to you by British Slang. Okay, let's move on. I'll record that in a second, but let's move on. What's the next thing I sang?
On the line.
Ah, okay. Where'd my... I just lost my pick. Okay. I sing on the live stream, I think. It's great lyrics.
On the live stream.
Yep.
On the...
And I change chords. I go to what is now the fifth chord in the progression. So I change. I'm playing an E right now for anyone who's piano minded.
On the
So I'm singing that note
on the live.
And so the melody is going down
on the live stream.
I think I stay on that note. Yeah.
Live stream.
Okay, so we've got, but we're on a new chord. So our rules stay the same, but our chord changes, and so our tone options, the tonal scale intervals, change. Okay, great. I should copyright those lyrics. I should. Yeah, I should. I'm going to start copyright striking anybody who's got a YouTube video that goes ding dong. I'll be like, that's mine. Okay, so
on the line.
So I'm playing a, what is known as that? That's a B. And I need, let's sing our 1-3-5s.
Bum, 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 bum.
So that would be our next chord interval above do. So
on the.
And so dum, dum, dum. So what does that tell us? So when we were singing on this note,
on the,
I was singing this note.
Da-da, on the.
And then when the chord changes, the melody goes down
on the live stream.
But because my chord changes, this note, my harmony stays the same.
On the live stream.
Watch, I'll do it. What's I do?
Harmony.
Okay, I'm gonna record the whole thing. So we're gonna go
harmony on the live.
And then I'm going to stay on the same note.
The live stream.
Right? It's just the do, 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 Those are the three tones of that chord. So let's record that. Switch over to my reverb track. Hey guys, I'm lost in a well.
Harmony.
I can do that better.
Harmony on the live stream.
Great. We'll call that good. Let's tweak it. Do this. Okay. Close. Turn down a little bit. Let's play back.
Harmony on the live stream.
Great. Okay, now let's do the next one.
Harmony.
Harmony. Okay, now I'm going to start going a little faster here. What do we hear there? If we hear
harmony,
are you guys starting to feel the chord and the tones?
Harmony, what are our tones? Bum, 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 bum.
Harmony, we're back, we're actually starting, we're on the first chord. It's actually identical to what's over here.
Harmony.
So our choice is the same.
Harmony.
Harmony. Let me get it together.
Harmony.
Same thing. Now let's take a look at this.
We sing harmony.
Hey, look at that. It's the same thing. I do the same.
Sing harmony.
Great. Easy peasy. Let's record it. Whoops. Hang on.
Harmony. We sing harmony.
It's probably good enough. Let's just tweak that a little bit. And we'll squish our... There we go.
We sing harmony.
Okay, now I did that one pretty fast. Why did I do that one fast? Because it's literally the same as the first one. So we needn't think it out loud again. We're doing the same exact thing, right? We cool on that? Cool. Okay. Let's move to the last phrase.
You and me sing harmony.
You. Okay, so there's our melody note.
You.
Let's do our 1-3-5s.
You, 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 you.
So I want to sing above.
You, 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 you,
you. Okay, that's our first note. Now, let's listen to this.
And me.
So,
you and me sing harmony.
That's what the melody's doing.
You and me, you and me sing harmony.
Okay, and we've got chord changes in there. So let's figure them out. We'll get the right tones at the right time.
You, 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 you.
Then it goes, and me. So a first note, and. And anyone do the 1-3-5s?
And
it gets a little high there, but
and
that's our next tone above. So the melody's going
you and you and me.
We'll get to the me, but you and we're gonna sing
you and
okay
you and.
Then it goes
me,
you. Now we've changed. This is where we change chords.
You and me.
So we've gone back to that E chord, and we're singing this note.
You and me.
Now we've already figured out a harmony interval for this. We've done it before. It's gonna be the same thing.
Do do
do do do do. That's our next tone above. And you'll notice if our harmony part leading up to that.
You and me.
You
and me.
It's gonna actually stay. The note is the same, but it's functioning differently in the chord.
So you and me sing harmony. You and me sing.
So far that's the same. Let's look at the rest of the melody.
Harmony. Sing harmony.
Okay, now what is that doing?
You and me sing. You sing ha ha. Harmony.
Now, okay. This is where I threw a curveball into the end part. What is what have I been doing the melody before this whole point? Up to this point, the melody has been playing or singing chord tones. Harmony, we sing harmony, that's all in the chord. Harmony, that's in the chord. On the live stream, that's all in the chord. But at the very end here, when it goes, you and me sing. Now watch this. Hear that? Harmony. There's notes there that are going outside of the chord. Right? So what do you do? Now that we our rules stay in the chord, and our melody went outside the chord. So the melody broke the rule. Now, why did the melody break the rule? Because if all we did in life was literally sing the chord tones, our melodies, all of our songs would be about as cool as this song. Harmony, we sing harmony. Harmony on the live. Like, that's not a, it's really not going to light up the world. It's because we're seeing these very obvious things. So the spice in melodic writing comes from those moving, being within the chord and moving outside the chord. Right? Suddenly, that's, I mean, on this melody, that last line is the most interesting melody part of the whole line. Not, I mean, the song's not winning awards anyway, but
you and me sing harmony.
That's the only part where it's like vaguely some kind of emotion.
Harmony.
So, how do we find our, let's figure out what we're going to do. We're going to sing, is it you?
Me sing harm.
Now, our melody note goes up outside of the chord. So what does our harmony note do? Well, the answer is you get to decide, sort of. So let's make the decision. One option we have is that we can say we are going to stay note adjacent. We're gonna go up. Rule number one, don't sing the same note. Rule number two, stay melody adjacent. And rule number three is to stay within the chord. Well, we could follow those rules and we could say that it doesn't matter that the melody is going outside the chord. We're gonna follow our rules. So we're gonna follow rule number one. We're not gonna sing the same note. Easy enough. We're gonna sing the next chord tone away from this. Even though this one's not a chord tone, we're gonna sing the nearest chord tone above this. And the nearest chord tone above that is the note we've already been on. So if this was harmony and we were saying we can just stay there. So
you and...
Let me actually do it with the thing. It's going to make more sense.
You and... You and me sing harmony.
See that?
Me sing harm.
Let me actually hear. Let's, dare I slow down the tempo so we can spend more time kind of thinking about it? Let's half time it and you'll hear it for a little longer. Maybe not quite half time. That'll work. Still calculating. There we go.
You and me sing harm.
So I'm staying on that same note.
Me sing harm.
Totally acceptable. Okay? Or we could make another choice. We could say, no, we don't want to. Maybe that, for whatever reason, we might think that maybe that sound is a little too clashing. It's not. But maybe we think it sounds too dissonant, and we actually want to go, we don't want to stay on that note. We want to go to the next chord tone above. We could...
Do, 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 do.
Those are our 1-3 vibes. Do, do, do. So we could go,
sing,
let's see,
you and me sing harm.
I could go up there. I wouldn't. I think that the combination, even though this note goes outside the scale, that still sounds pleasant to me. So I'm happy to stay there. Okay, let's figure out the rest of the harmony, and we almost got our part down.
Me sing harm. Me sing harmony.
So So, okay, so harmony. Nee, 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 nee. Okay, so nee. That's what the melody is doing. It's going back to the original chord and it's singing doo. And so what is our harmony note? It's the same one that we solved up here because it's the same melody note. Nee, doo, doo, harmony, nee. Put it all together. Let me get rid of my slowdown there.
You and me sing harmony.
Right? That's it. Let's record it. Let me find my notes.
You.
There it is. Oh, whoops. We don't want that to slow down. There we go.
You.
We can do better.
You and me sing harmony.
Good enough. Let's correct it. Squish it.
You and me sing harmony.
Great. Guys, we just wrote a harmony. Let's listen to the whole thing.
Harmony. We sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. You and me sing harmony.
Okay, that's it. Let's put a harmony below that. What we just did was called the tenor part. In certain other people might call something else. We're gonna call it the tenor part because that's what a lot of people refer to it. Thank you, Adam. This is really nice. I don't think you really mean the song, but okay. The song is at best entirely forgettable. But okay. Now let's do the part below. What in my parlance and people that I know and work with refer to as the baritone part, the part that is one chord degree below the melody. Now the process is all the same. We're going to do the same exact stuff. So let's figure it out. Somewhere my phone just made a noise. Oh, okay, that's okay. Okay, so let's go a little faster here because, you know, time ain't getting shorter. Harmony, that's what my melody was. Remember harmony, let's refresh the melody.
We sing harmony.
Okay, so we're gonna do the same exact things.
Harmony, dam.
Now, here's a... you're going to hear me doorbelling a lot here because on the baritone part, we can always, if we want to find the baritone note, we can always doorbell our way to it.
Dang.
How does the doorbell go? Bing bong, bing bong, bing bong. There it is. Bing bong. So what is our note?
Harmony, harmony, harmony.
And then
we sing,
same thing.
Harmony, we sing.
Then the chord changes. But now the chord changes. We've got a new chord.
Ba 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 bang 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 bang. Wait, bang 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 bang.
Oops, bang 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 dang dang dang. There we go. Sometimes I have to recenter myself in the chord.
Do 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 do.
There we go. So our chord changes.
We sing har,
but let's doorbell.
Dang, bing, bong, bing, bong.
So before we were going,
bing, bong, bing, bong.
Now we're gonna change chords.
Bing, bing, bong.
So those are our two notes. I'll show you what I mean. I'm gonna go quick on these just because we're following the same rules. So I'm not gonna rehash them over and over and over again for you guys, but let's just kind of put this part on a little quicker.
Harmony,
harmony, there it is.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Oh, things changed. We got to fix that. Did you hear what happened? Let me see if I can, let me do this actually. Let me mute my higher part. Okay, now watch what happened.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Uh-oh, did you hear what happened there? I'll even mute the guitar and see if I can do it without the guitar just to really show you what's happening.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Oh no, I'm doubling. I broke rule number one. Because the melody goes harmony. So what do we need to do? We need to, that's right. Ryan just broke rule number one. Thank you, Stefan. We need to, the melody is moving and we need to get out of its way. So, okay, fair enough, easy enough. Well, let's bing bong our way out of here. So, harmony. Now I'm singing that note in the melody. So what does our doorbell do? Ding, 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 dong, dong. There's our note. That's our chord tone below. Ding, dong, harmony. So if I was singing harmony, we sing harmony. Now I've gotten out of the way. Does that make sense? If going that fast makes sense to you guys, then I'm going to record this. If going that fast did not make sense to you guys, I will explain it more. And you tell me in the comments if where we're at on that, okay? Ryan and Garfunkel, harm my knee. Yeah, sure enough. The ding-dong sessions. Yeah, exactly. Just doorbell it. There you go. I am driving. Yeah, just doorbell it. That'll be my book, Harmony. I am Harmony and so can you. Just doorbell it. Okay, so Yuhani says it makes sense. Bill says it makes sense. Okay, let's put it on. Let's do it. Okay, I'm gonna go to my reverb track. Let's record it. Oop, I gotta turn on the guitar though. There we go. Bye.
Harmony, harmony, is that an
harm? Yep, that's the note. Harmony. Here we go.
Harmony.
Well, I can do a little better.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Good enough. Pitch edit. Correct. Squish. Let's listen to it.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Okay, let's move on. Let's go here.
Harmony.
Okay, moving quick. We know what the melody does. It goes har. Is that it? Oh, that's right. That's a million note. Harmony.
Harmony.
And so first note, harm. What's our doorbell baritone part below? Ding, bing, bong. Harm. Then our melody goes up.
Harmony.
And we are going to go up with it, but we're going to go up to the next chord tone. So let's bing, bong from here.
Bing, bing, bong, 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 bong. Harmony.
There it is. Let's take a listen to how that sounds.
Harmony.
Again, let me mute the high one so we're not getting thrown with the, here's just melody and low.
Harmony.
Sounds right. Yeah. I'll do it again.
Harmony.
Perfect. Great. Let's do it. I'll just do this kind of piecemeal here. I'll do this one real quick.
Harmony.
Sure. Put it here. Pitch edit. Tweak it. Flawless. Okay, here's our full stack.
Harmony.
Great. Now let's do this one. Melody. Let's mute our top part.
On the live stream. On the live.
Okay, so we're gonna
on the.
So we got that note.
On the da 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 ding dong on the.
Then it goes live on this chord.
Bong, bong.
What would be a doorbell on this, or what are our 1-3-5s?
Bum 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 bum.
And we're singing this note.
Dun da dum. Bing bong. Bing bong.
No. Ryan the guitarist almost let his guitar bias him. Did anyone catch this? I was going ding dong because if I'm playing guitar, ding dong, that's the next, feels like the next chord's the next string below the one I'm doing. But is it? Is that how a doorbell sounds? Ding dong. No, that's more like oh wee oh wee oh. That's a different interval. Bing bong. That's a doorbell. Bing bong. I'm not actually fretting that note on my guitar, so I nearly got thrown by it. So, ding, ding, dong, dong, that is our note for the lower part, ding, bong. Let's see how that factors in with our melody.
On the
live, so it goes here, and I go here, live stream.
On the live stream.
Oh, you're not hearing me, huh? Hang on.
On the live stream.
You hear that?
Live stream.
Now, this is actually a thing you'll notice. It's easier, this is a general rule, it's easier to find the part above the melody than it is just below the melody. The one above tends to be, when you get to the point of doing this on the fly, it tends to be the one that on the fly is faster than the lower one. The lower ones sometimes have these kind of weird, they feel a little weird to sing at first.
On the live, that's kind of a weird one to sing on that chord.
Feels a little weird physically. So, let's put that down. On the
live stream.
Okay, I'm gonna put it on.
On the live stream.
Great. Let's drop it down here. Pitch edit it. Squish it. That one's actually almost on pitch.
On the live stream.
Okay. Now let's go here. Oh, now remember this one, this part of the phrase. Hang on. Jump over here. This part of the melody was identical to the beginning, so we can do that quick too.
Harmony, we sing harmony.
Same exact thing. Let me just record that real quick. Whoops.
Live stream. Harmony. We sing harmony.
Okay, now if that all went down pretty quick, the reason it went down quick is because, let me just correct it, is because it's the same as this. So here, I'll solo.
Harmony, we sing harmony. Harmony, we sing harmony.
There you go. Same exact part, same melody, same chords. Just doubled it. Okay. Now let's get to this end phrase. Remember, the end phrase was the one that went a little bit outside of the melody, went outside of the scale tone. So let's see what happens there.
You and me sing harmony.
Remember that? I would pay good money for a music video of Ryan in a cowboy outfit singing this song. I'll show you when we get to, we're going to get to another example before our day is through. And you're going to see we're going to do the same thing. It's just going to sound less like a cowboy song. But okay, so.
You.
Okay, so we're starting here.
You.
So what we can do? Bing, bing, bong, bing, bong.
You.
That's our first note.
You and me. You and me.
Okay. So we're going to go. Then and. Ding dong. That's our next note. Da, 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 da.
You and.
Okay. We're going to just go that far.
You. And me. You.
There it is.
You.
That's one of those ones I said, they're kind of hard to sing, a weird interval.
You and me.
Okay, oops, sorry, I started doing it just intuitively. Let's get into it. Yes, so it changes chords, it goes to that E.
You and me.
So now the melody's here. And where's my bing bong? That's my note. So if I'm
you and me,
that's where it goes.
You and me sing.
Okay?
You and me sing.
That's as far as we're going to go. But I'm doing that a little bit faster again. And let me know if we're cool on that. It's because we're changing chords. So I'm now... And me, I've landed on a different chord. So I'm singing the one chord interval away from the melody note on the new chord. Not on the chord I was on, but on the new chord. Me, me. Okay? Eric's Wag says, you can test harmonies with a vocal synth. You could. Yes, you can. And if I were doing a tweakier workshop, there's things we can do when we start playing with harmony where we use technology. But to teach fundamentals, we're sticking to just singing so you actually get it. Okay, so
you and me sing.
Now, here's the weird part. The melody goes, harmony, right? Now, if I, I'm on this chord, sing harm, now my melody has gone outside of the chord. And so remember on our previous one, we had to make a choice. Do we move to the next highest when we were doing the higher harmony? Do we move to the next highest chord interval to move in parallel with that melody note going higher? Or do we stay on the chord tone that we're on because it's still the nearest adjacent chord tone? We have to make that same choice here. Let's figure it out. So we could, when the melody note goes,
you and me sing harm, harm, harm.
And I'm singing harm. So I could, I'm going to play two notes at once.
Sing harm.
This is, there you go. You're going to start to get the answer there. Does this sound good? Not so much. Certain artists love that sound. But for what we're doing right now, no, we were going to say that doesn't sound quite good. Does this sound good when it goes, harm? This sounds okay. Technically it's an interval called a fourth.
Sing harm, harm.
It's okay. And you might like it, and you might choose to leave it. Or this is in let's do the let's actually break the rule in concert with our melody. And let's go up along with it. So we're gonna go. Whoops, sorry.
Sing harm, harm, harm.
So that went up, and we're gonna go harm, harm, harm.
You and me sing harm.
We just temporarily go harm, harm, harm. Okay? All we're doing is just, we're just moving up in the scale to move with the melody. The melody broke the rule, so we're going to break the rule with it. We had that choice. We don't have to. We could stay on the note that we had, or we could break the rule.
You and me sing harm.
Hear that?
Me sing harm.
Let me slow. I have this whole tempo thing here, so I can slow it down again.
Me sing harm. You and me sing harm.
So, or we could keep it the same.
You and me sing harm.
Equally acceptable. That your choice. Chef's choice on that one. Let me know in the comments if what you want to do. Stay the same or move up in concert with it. You guys tell me. But let's figure out the rest of the phrase while you're catching up, because there's a delay on the stream.
Harmony, harmony.
Okay, so we're going to go back to this note. Harmony is our last note. And we're going to go down...
ding dong, harmony, knee.
Okay, that's gonna be our last note, harmony. I'll look to see. Kim says stay the same. it'd work if you slow that final part to close the song. Yes, you're right. If we were really making the song, I could slow the tempo down. It would be a big grand harmony, but we're not going to do that. Okay, but so let's start putting together our choices. So
you and me sing harmony.
That would be option one, where it stays on the note.
And me sing harmony.
Or
me sing harmony.
Do you hear the difference there? Sing harmony, sing harmony. Do a vocal run at the end, Miguel says. Whoa, whoa. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so Michael's saying switch it. Michael wins the day. We're going to switch it then. Okay, so here, let's just put this down.
You and me sing harmony.
Okay, there we are. Now, let's, you know the drill. We're going to correct it. Woo. Correct it. Squish it. Listen.
You.
Oh boy. We got a wrong note there. You. There it is.
You.
There it is.
You and me.
Oh, wrong note again. Oh, Ryan. What are you doing?
You. And me.
Gonna fix this is a fix it in the mix for time's sake. We're not gonna re-record it.
And me sing harmony. And me sing harmony.
There it is. Okay. Guys, let me jump back here so you're not listening to me trapped in a well. Let's take a listen to the whole thing. We have three parts here now. Let's just listen to before I put on the high one, let's just listen to our low part with our melody.
Harmony, we sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. And me sing harmony.
There you go. Yeah, and yes, push button has got. Now I come in with yo yo yo, check this out, and then that's where the rapper comes in and just blows everybody's mind with some sick beats. No, but okay, so that's a nice little part together. Let's put on the third part and listen to the whole stack now together.
Harmony. We sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. You and me sing harmony.
Okay, now let's do this just for maximum listening. We're gonna mute the guitar and just listen to our stack as it is.
Harmony, we sing.
I'm gonna mention this because we've done this and we've all walked through this together. What you're gonna hear when you listen to the vocals, the acapella only, you're gonna hear and feel the chords change underneath, even though the guitar is gone. Okay.
Harmony, we sing harmony. Harmony on the live stream. Harmony, we sing harmony. You and me sing harmony.
Do you feel those chords changing even though they're not there? And the reason that they're not, the reason you feel them even when they're not there is because they are there. Because we built them into our harmony. We're singing the chord tones. So as we have made the correct decisions, you can remove the chords of the song, the sort of the rhythm track of the song, and the harmonic structure of the song is still going. So 337 Media Studios. My daughter's name is Harmony. Well, there you go. I just wrote her a song. You can sing it for bedtime or something. So that is okay. Now here's let's real talk for a second. There's one problem, and that is this song is cheesy as all get out. Right? I mean, I get it. I saw people say things in there where they were like, it's a barbershop. Sounds like a barbershop. Well, yeah, because barbershop uses very similar rules. Their chords are different, and they break the rules in special ways, but they're working off a similar set of rules. And so this sounds cheesy because, well, a number of reasons. Because it's not exactly lighting the world on fire as a melody. It's not lighting the world on fire as a chord progression or a guitar performance or the lyrics or all of these things. But the rules that are happening are the same if we move into a cooler song. And so you guys tell me, I would love to do another song now. If you're down for it, if you're down to watch me keep going, I know we've gone a while here. And if people who are still with me or coming in late want to do it on a more modern song, I have a more modern song that actually comes from a viewer submission and a friend of the stream. And we can apply the same thing. Yohani says yes with 4 exclamation points. So if someone might have to out exclaim him if they feel otherwise. Electric banjo, yeah. Let's do this, push button. Hell yes, says Mark. Let's do it, says Jeremy. I'm so down, says 337. Okay, so let's bring up another song. I got to do a little bit of switcheroo stuff in order to make this happen. So you're going to probably watch me in silence. Talk amongst yourselves over there in the chat while we do this. And I'm going to open up another song. Hang on, I'll be back with you on the other side of the dark side of the moon. I think I'm still with you. Oh, I am still with you. Okay, now wait, now let me make a little change to the visuals. Bear with me. I would love it if there was a way to do this super fast and easy. But once I switch reason songs, I got to do some switcheroos. So let's do this. Do this. Do this. And this. I think that's going to do it for us. Let me just make some adjustments. Okay, now I gotta create an audio track in my other thing. Hang on, you're gonna be with me in a second on the audio. Am I back? I am back, but wait, something's funky. Let me just double check something here. Do I have the wrong version open? Hang on. Nope, I look to be okay. I think that's okay. Okay, so turn on my gate. My poor iMac is blowing its fans to do all this stuff with us here. Okay, so let's switch over here. So we've got this other song. This song comes from I'm gonna do this. Hang on. There we are. Ba-ding. This song comes from a regular stream. A guy you may have seen in the chat. He's in the chat there. I've seen him commenting in here. This is a guy named Michael Wood, and Michael's got a sort of a duo that he works with. He writes with named Ukadian. It's a Canadian UK sort of portmanteau group, and this was actually a song, if I'm remembering correctly, it's one that he put in the Dropbox when we did a previous stream, and it was I heard it and I thought like, oh, that would be a nice one to actually talk about the harmonies for. So let's take a listen. Michael and Ukadian it's a very pop, modern pop sort of sound, you know, that sort of very, just like purely crafted kind of pop melodies and pop tones. So let's take a listen to his tune for a second and then see where we're going to fit into it. Thank you.
I can't help but protect you when you say you need me and need you too. But it's you that's hurting, it's you that's cold. I'm your soldier on when you're about to fold. When the room gets dark and you're all alone, I'm right there with you, yeah, yeah.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side. My love for you is never ending.
Okay. That's a nice little tune. So first of all, like, you know, let's give a applause to Michael. Thank you for letting us use this, and what a great tune. I'm seeing sounds like a Britney song. Yeah, it does. It really does have, I've noticed this from Michael's writing. Michael really does have that, you know, sort of that Max Martin era boy band and Britney sort of instincts. And that's not an easy thing to do in a convincing way. You can really, if you fail at doing that, it really sounds terrible really quickly. So kudos to you guys, UKadian, for doing that well. But so, okay, so we've got, this is a more realistic one. Like instantly we're not in a, it's not a cowboy song anymore. And let's go ahead and consider what we would do as producers. So this starts with a verse.
I can't help but protect you when you say.
Now, if I went in and started putting harmony on this,
I can't help but protect you.
Like, I could do it, but why? This is a creative choice. Like, no, it's starting in this really beautiful sort of soft thing. Like, don't step on it with harmony already. So we're just going to let, I think this might be Michael singing the lead. Michael, correct me if I'm wrong here, if you're watching. But this, we're going to let him sing it alone.
I can't help but protect you when you say you need me and need you too. But it's you that's hurting, it's you that.
Now, as a producer, we're not going to do this section, but as a producer, I could make the decision to bring in a harmony here, right? I could say, okay, the song's going to build and I'm going to bring in a voice that kind of goes like this. I'm going to do it this is that on the fly thing. In fact, while I do this, I may get it wrong, but while I do this on the fly, you'll start noticing I'm just going to be following in a quicker form the same rules we just did on the previous example.
Need you to. But it's you that's hurting, it's you that's gold. I'm your soldier, when you're involved.
That's kind of like, that's me starting to work out the harmony. I could bring it in there, but let's not.
But it's you that's hurting, it's you that's cold. I'm your soldier, on when you're about to fold. When the room gets dark and you're all alone, I'm right there.
Now, here we've arrived at the chorus. Chorus, perfect time to bring in a harmony. No one is going to criticize you for bringing in a harmony there. So I'm going to talk through the taste. I know this isn't a production tutorial, but my decision on not bringing in the harmony earlier is because we want our song to build. I mean, just generally speaking, that's like not a bad goal to have your song kind of build and develop in intensity. And that's already covered in this part where I decided not to put harmony. That's already covered by the piano changing from being a very sparse piano to being that arpeggio piano.
You need me and need you too. But it's you that's hurting, it's you that's cold. I'm your soul.
It's already got that build element, so I don't need to come in with the harmony. If that piano continued to be sparse, then I might have a different musical producerial instinct to actually put a harmony there because I want some development. But Michael's covered it with the piano, no need to throw in too many tricks at once. So I'm going to wait until the chorus. I'm going to put a harmony in the chorus. I saw a comment. Yes, yeah, so, Bill says, bring harmonies in as a surprise. Establish the song first. That's a totally valid viewpoint, Bill. That is correct. And someone else, I saw another thing. Does harmony have to be high? No, it doesn't have to be high. You could, and if you may have tuned in a little late, Wolf, but in the very beginning, I was showing some graphics. And in fact, here, I'll dare jump back to this for a second. When we're making harmonies, we can do it like this, where the lead, that orange note, is our melody note, and we put two harmonies above it. Or we could do this, where we've got the same melody note in orange, and we've actually stacked two harmony notes below. The same rules apply, the same techniques apply. It has a different sound, and for different types of groups, vocal groups, you can make those choices. For pop production, like what I'm going to do with Michael, I am going to put Michael in the middle, or maybe Gavin, looking at the track names. One of the lead vocal, we're going to put in the middle, and I'm going to add a harmony above it. And because it's already pretty high for male vocal, I'll show you, I don't think I could even go higher above it, but I could go lower, so I can do that. Okay, so let's take a look at that. Okay, so I'm gonna switch over to this. Let's take a look at the chorus. Now, first thing I need to do as a producer is I need to figure out what the chords are. I didn't write the song, so I'm just coming in as a producer. I mean, not really. Don't worry, Michael, I'm not coming in as a producer. You don't have to give me 15%.
Be scared, I'll be there, put your trust in me, and stop pretending.
I'm going to temporarily just mute the vocal. Okay, that's... That is our chord progression. Okay, so there it is. This is a pretty standard chord progression that they're using. It's the if people know the Access of Awesome video, I'm pretty sure this is the Access of Awesome sort of classic. Million hits have been written with this chord progression. Okay, so now we know our chords. Knowing our chords now, I can start looking at Gavin's melody, learning his melody, and then learning where I fit into it. We're going to do this a little quicker than we did the last one, but, you know.
Don't be scared.
Okay. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. Okay. So, don't be scared. That's what he's doing. Don't be scared. Now we got a chord change there, so let's just think through our first two notes while we're on this chord. The first chord. Don't. Now, if I want to put a harmony above that, bum. It's the same stuff we did on the last one. Do, 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 do. Those are my 1s, 3s, and 5s. Do, 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 do. So that's my harmony note. Do, don't. Let's just sing just that much with him. Don't be. Okay. It's coming quick there, but yeah. Don't. And so he goes, don't be. And so we're going to follow him. We're going to go, don't. Then he goes down. And we're going to go down to follow him. We're going to go down in the same chord interval, to the nearest chord interval. So he's singing this note, don't be. And we're going to find bum, 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 bum. Same stuff we were doing on our goofy little song in the beginning. Bum, 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 bum. So if he's going, don't be, we go, don't be, right? Now what happens? We change chords.
Scared,
don't be scared. Now he's got a little he sort of delays. Don't be scared. He sort of delays moving into the chord on his melody note. This is one of those, like, the spice that makes the melodies a little more interesting. For now, let's just think about the note he lands on. Scared, let's simplify his melody. Don't be scared, scared. Okay, so he's singing scared. What is our next chord tone above this note? Scared on this chord. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Same, we can do all the hello, hello, hello. Any of those little tricks, you know, the Beatles. Anyway, I can't not go, it's like, I can't not go to that fourth chord. Anyway, so, dum, dum. So that's our note above. Ding. So let's just back up for a second. He goes, don't be scared. And we're going, don't be. And then what do we say our next note is? Scared, scared. So while he's doing, if you listen to his contour, he's sort of going high, low, middle, a note in between. Da, da, da. But the way that our harmony strategy works out, we're actually going, da, don't be scared. We're going back to the note we started on, but because the chord changes, it's a different interval within the chord. Don't be scared. So let's just do that for a second.
Don't be scared.
Let's just take that much. Don't be scared.
Don't be scared.
Now here's another, maybe just a worth mentioning. When you're doing harmony, even though, remember I said that he's delaying his move into that. We simplified it when we were writing. Don't be scared. But he's actually going, don't be scared. He's like, not quite scooping, but he's, don't be scared. So I have to follow that. I can't actually go, don't be scared. I have to go, don't be scared. I have to delay with him. So that's what we want to do when we're doing harmonies. We want to follow the lead. Lead gets to determine the phrasing. So,
don't be scared.
Okay. Making sense? Dare I record just that? No, let me get this whole phrase.
Don't be scared.
Now let's hear what he does.
I'll be there.
Okay, so we change chords again. I'll be. Now here he's doing that. Remember that thing? He's doing exactly what I did on my song where he's going outside the chord. The chord is staying here. And he's moving outside of it. Those two notes, I'll be, are not in the chord that's happening. So we have to make the same choices that we made before. And in the last one, and we'll probably do the same thing, we stayed in the chord tone. So he's going outside. So,
don't be scared, I'll be.
And our harmony is, don't be scared. And then I could either try and follow him,
I'll be.
Or I could just stay,
I'll be, don't be scared, I'll be.
And then we change chords. My instinct is, and especially for this fundamental stuff, is to stay on the chord, stay in the chord. Rule number three, stay in the chord. Can't go wrong if you stay in the chord, except sometimes when you do, which you'll discover and you'll fix. Every now and again, there's moments where we might choose to break that rule. But for now, stay in the chord.
Don't be scared, I'll be.
Now the melody goes,
don't be scared, I'll be there. Da, da, da.
So he's,
I'll be there.
Now he's gone to a minor chord, which means now we're on a minor chord. We kind of, the 1-3-5 still applies, but we can't quite do the, on a minor chord, we can't do the old Beatles thing. It's different. but we can still practice singing these
dum 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 dum.
These are all the notes of our minor chord. So we can find if I did it on a piano, I don't have a piano in front of me here, easily. But if I played an E minor chord and I find this note, which he's singing in, I'm sorry, not E minor, it's F sharp minor, I have a capo on. If I play the next chord tone above That is this. That would be a someone who knows theory better or notation better than me would either call this a D flat or a C sharp. I guess C sharp. I'm gonna call it a C sharp. But it doesn't matter what the actual note is. It matters how it sounds with the chord. So he's going, don't be scared. And we're gonna go, don't be scared. So he got melody, just refreshing here. Don't be scared, I'll be there. That's the words, right? Is that the words? Sorry, Michael.
I'll be there.
Yeah, I'll be there. Don't be scared, I'll be there. And our harmony. Don't be scared, I'll be there. There, there. Here, that's just still one chord tone away. Somebody, I'll be there. Make sense, guys? Hope so. Okay.
Don't be scared.
Dwayne says he can't stop singing harmony. We sing harmony. It's going to be in your head all day.
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
You hear that?
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
All right. Let's figure out the next part of the phrase.
Put your trust in me.
Put your trust. Put your trust. Know what he's doing. Put your trust. Oh, yeah, okay. Put your trust in me. Okay, so he goes outside the melody again a little bit, but we'll solve that.
Put your trust in me.
Let's figure out the sort of the fence posts of that.
Put.
So he's singing this, put, and I'm gonna sing the next chord tone up,
put.
Then he goes to that note, so I gotta get out of his way.
Put your.
I'm just moving up in that chord. He goes put your. I go put your. Right?
Put your.
And then he goes trust in. And then he lands on me. New chord. It's a major chord, so we can do our old 1-3-5.
Bum 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 bum.
So
put your trust in me. Me,
put your trust in me, right? Is that making sense? Okay, so let's lead up to that and see how we get it.
Yeah, put your trust in me.
Hang on.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Trust in me. Okay. I think that's the whole phrase. Now, listen, something happened there naturally.
Be there, put your...
Remember I said he goes outside?
Put your trust in me.
Put your trust. He goes outside of the chord. And when I sang with it, what I naturally did is, I don't even know if I can do it. If I tried to stay,
put your.
Do you hear that? Not the world's coolest harmony. So what my voice naturally did was moved up. It went outside the scale too in order to accommodate his going outside the chord, excuse me. Inside the scale, outside the chord. So I go,
put your trust.
He goes, put your trust. And I'm going to go,
put your trust. Put your trust in me. Trust in me.
Is that it?
Trust in me.
Or maybe stays. It happens naturally. It's like you don't need to necessarily overthink that. It's like just... gravity will pull you to that right note on little passing phrases like that. So let me just go ahead and record this. Hopefully get it right. You guys are hanging in, you're troopers. All right, let's do this. Wait.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
That's the line. Okay.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
I think that's right. Let me listen back.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Okay. now we're going to going to help Ryan's pitch a little bit. A lot.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Okay. Now we're gonna also help Ryan's complete lack of vocal treatment by throwing a reverb. Whoa. Oh no, wait, that's not a reverb. Hey now. Is it three? Hey, whoa, yeah, there we are. Okay.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Okay, now we got our first line. Oh boy, let me go back here. Is that better? Yeah, can you hear me okay? Oh wait, oh, I turned me down. Hang on, I'm back. Let's turn this one down. Okay, there we go. Okay, let's take a look at the next phrase.
And stop it, say.
Now, is it worth saying already? If you notice, modern song, same rules. It's the same rules that resulted in our cheesy cowboy song because we were writing a cheesy cowboy song, but now we're writing a cheesy pop song. No, I'm kidding, Michael. We're writing a crafted pop song. And so it ends up following and sounding the way it needs to because it's the same rules applied to just a different style.
Don't be scared, I'll be there.
I gotta move this down. That's what I gotta do. Okay.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Okay, now let's take a look at this.
And start pretending.
Okay, let's figure that one out. And start pretending. So we're on the last chord of the... And start pretending. Start pretending. Pretending. Ah, okay, we changed chords again. So, and start pretending. So we can figure this one out real easy. Start. What's the... On this chord. D, 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 D. Our next note above, D, D, and start pretend, start pretend. Stop, is it stop or start? Michael, hang on.
And stop pretend.
Start pretending? You tell me, I can't quite tell. Start pretending, I think it is. So start pretend. Now can you, I'm not gonna give you the answer. I just wanna see if you feel, if you're starting to feel the harmonic gravity pull you to the right chord tone. And sing if you're, I hope people are singing this at home. And start pretend. Ding. What is the ding?
Start pretend. Ding. Is that where you got?
If that, listen to his melody and start
pretending.
Oh, it's stop. Stop. Michael says stop. Stop pretending. Okay.
And stop pretending.
So he's going, and stop pretending. And we want to, and we can do it the slow way. We da, da, na, 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 na. Stop pretending. But if we just sing the line, you start to feel the intuitive nature of these chord tones. And start pretending. Stop. I'm gonna be doing that wrong now forever, Michael. Sorry.
And stop pretending.
Right? Okay. That's the last part of our line. So let's just take a look at that for a second.
Trust in me. And stop pretending.
Oh wait, let me turn this on.
And stop pretending.
Okay, now I'm gonna just put a pin in that for a second. Let's see where else he goes.
I'll always be there. Be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Now guys, do you realize what's happening there? This is the beauty of pop music. It's part of the charm of pop music, and it also makes our job easy because the melody is repeating. The chord progression repeats, the melody repeats, and so what does our harmony do? Our harmony repeats. So
and stop pretending, I'll always be there.
Okay, now I need to learn the words here. I'll always be there.
I'll always be there. I'll be by your side.
By your side.
Because my love for you is never ending.
Okay, so the harmony notes are the same. So let's just refresh what we did here.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me. And stop pretending. I'll always be there. Your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
See what happened there? sang the same exact intervals because the melody was doing the same thing. Different words, different syllables, different phrasing, different timing, because he's fitting different words over the thing. But the contour of the melody stays the same, and so the contour of a harmony stays the same. Okay, let's do it. Let's put it down. This one might take me a little while to get the words right and the phrasing right, but let's do a couple of takes.
Put your trust in me and stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
That was actually okay. Dare we call that, can it be that easy? Should it be that easy? Maybe it's okay. Let's just go for it. Okay. I didn't hate it. I mean, maybe I'll hate it when I play it back, but that was all right. So I'm going to I didn't even have to correct it that much. I'm going to squish it just a little bit. Let's take a listen. Let's move it down to my other track here.
And stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Guys, we just wrote a harmony to our chorus. Let's back up. Let's bring back in Michael's vocal. Michael, correct me if I'm wrong. So you start the song, you sing the verse, and then Gavin sings the chorus. Is that kind of the way that this duet's happening?
I'm right there with you, yeah, yeah.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for it's never ending.
There we are. I hope that for people that started with this process as a mystery at the beginning of the stream, this feels less mysterious. This feels more formulaic. And I say formulaic in a good way because, again, let's call this the Giles principle, that we learn the fundamentals and apply the fundamentals, and then our taste will let us decide when we want to break the rules. There's times where you can move outside of the chord strategically and you can flavor up your harmonies a little bit, but for this, and certainly for this type of song, we might want to just stay totally rigid on this. So okay, now next order of business.
Don't be scared.
Now should we try and put a harmony? We have a choice here. Well, we might not have a choice. Our choice might be dictated by my voice vocal range. I think we're going to have to do is put a vocal a harmony below it. Because if I wanted to, don't be scared, that's very high up, I don't think I can sing up that high in a good way. So we're gonna put a harmony below this. This would be what we call the baritone harmony. And let me go ahead and start working that out. Same rules apply. Now we just know this melody and chord progression pretty well, so we can figure it out.
Don't be scared.
That's what it goes. Don't be. That's how it began. So, if that's our melody note, we're going to start here. Don't. And then the melody goes, don't be. So I got to get out of the way. Don't. And then I need, don't. Anyone? Is anyone feeling the note already? If we just sang the do, 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 bing bong, we could use bing bong theory. Bong, bing bong. So, don't be. And then the chord changes. And so we're going, don't be
scared.
Wait, what does he do?
Don't be scared. Bing, 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 bong.
There's our bing bong, the lower ones. Bong bong. So,
don't be scared.
That's our first three notes. Makes sense? We're doing the same thing we did on the first example. Okay? Then will the melody go see?
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
That's that where he moves outside the melody. But the basic contour is he's going,
I'll be there.
He's landing there.
There. There.
What's one tone below?
There.
There. So we were here.
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
right? Now, we have the same, we could make that same choice. We could go, because he goes outside the melody. Just like in our last example, we could go, don't be scared, I'll be there. We could like try and follow him a little bit, or we could just stay. I'll be there. Let's stay. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Okay, then what does he do? Oh yeah, let me mute my other harmony.
Put your trust in me.
Okay, so put your trust in me. And I need to find, it's a new chord, so I need to find the new chord tone. Guess what? The chord tone below, oh boy, look, Reverb City. The chord tone below an E minor, I'm sorry, F sharp minor, I'm capoed. An F sharp minor and a D, the chord tone between these. I don't know if you can see my hand. I wonder if my, do I have the right thing? So yeah. See how I'm switching chords? I'm switching chords, but the two tones aren't changing. That's because they share, the chords share those tones. They're different intervals within the chord, but they're the same tones. So because his, put your trust in me. We can just go, put your trust in me. Stay on there, right? Okay. We got that part solved, so let's just review.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me.
Okay? And then
in me and stop pretending.
And then he goes up. And start pretending. Okay, so and start stop. Oh, sorry, Michael. Stop pretending. Okay, so what's our bing bong? Let's bing bong our way down there. Bing, 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 bong, bong. There it is. Bing bong. Who knew that your entire life, by just having the doorbell ring, you were learning to write vocal harmonies? It's the best training we ever got. Bing bong. Okay, so, and stop, pretend. Okay, then he goes, stop pretending. And we change chords. And stop pretending. Now, what's our bing bong on this new chord? Bing, 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 bong. Right? Feels like a doorbell. Bing, bong, bing, bong. Okay, now, what does that tell us? Bing, 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 bong, bing, bong. It's the same note, but this note's not changing. Why does it sound like a doorbell both times? I don't know, it's magic. No, it's not really magic, but it's just the way major chords work. But, he goes, and stop pretending, and our lower harmony is gonna go, and stop pretending, and stay there. Okay, so, reviewing the lower harmony. I'll be there. What's the line? Sorry, Michael. What's your thing?
I'll be there. Put your trust.
Oh no, sorry.
Don't
be scared.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending.
Right? Let's listen to how that sounds with the melody. I'm gonna sing it over top, see if it works. But I'm going to first monitor my input.
Don't be scared, I'll be there, put your trust in me.
Oh. Trust in me. Oh no, that's right, okay.
I'll be there, put your...
My backup.
Don't be scared, I'll be there, put your trust in me. And stop pretending.
Stop pretending. Okay. So, like I said, lower harmonies, a little weirder to sing. You hear my voice a little shakier trying to find those pitches. We got the idea of what we want. It's just I got to actually figure out how to intonate it with my voice. We're going to maybe do a couple of takes there to try and figure it out.
Hey, yeah. Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me. And stop pretending, I'll always be there.
I'll always
I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay, that's pretty close. I'm gonna try and record this for the sake of time and hope that I just have another little moment of nailing the phrasing and getting the words right and all that. Let's try it.
With you, yeah, yeah. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
It's pretty close, actually. Actually, it was kind of close. Let's take a look. We're going to clean it up in pitch edit for sure. But let's do that. Correct. And actually, I'm going to solo this temporarily so that I can just hear if there's any funky, incorrect notes. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Oh. Oops, that's one. See that? I kind of went a little low there.
But I'll be there, put your trust in me, and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay, we're gonna call that good enough for jazz. Sadly, we're doing pop. It's not technically good enough for pop, but we're gonna call it good enough for live stream, I guess, right? Okay, so let's listen to that over the, I've still got the high one muted.
Don't be scared, I'll be there.
I gotta save myself and put a little reverb on this. So I'm gonna move this down here.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Sounds like a harmony, don't it? Let's put our other one on.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay, now, Michael, I saw you mention earlier when I was working on the other one about doubling, and when we get into production, we might, I mean, dare I take a few minutes and layer the stuff up? Let's do that. Let's do it. Why not, right? If you guys want to leave, you leave. Love it. I'm going to double the part that I just recorded while I still have it fresh in my mind. And then we're going to kind of just have a thicker layer. Let's see. Oh boy, here we go. Maybe this is a bad idea. If this is a bad idea, I'm going to stop.
Yeah, yeah. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay, I did two vocals. Now I'm gonna do this. Move that down here. Okay, then I'm going to, boy, I should probably start, this is when you need to start labeling your tracks. I'm gonna call this Barry left and Barry right. So now we've got two of the same part, more or less. And I'm gonna pan them, and I'm hoping that the broadcast is in stereo. And now we're gonna mute those. And then I'm going to jump back, and we're gonna do the high vocal. Let me refresh my memory on the high vocal.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never.
Yep, okay, got the part. Remember, I'm gonna record it again.
Hey, hey. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
Good enough, sort of. Now, on doubled vocals, I tend to be a little stricter on the pitch, so I'm going to do a little extra squish, because we can. This isn't exactly, don't take my word on this as a hard and fast rule, but I am going to do that. Okay, now, I'm moving fast, because we're actually, I don't know if you guys realize we're actually through the harmony part. Now we're just into the production part. So I'm gonna label the track I just did tenor right, and the one that I first did, which is this one, I think. Well, let's see, it's this one. Yeah, it's that one. I'm gonna label this tenor left, and then I'm gonna pan them. And now we've got thicker harmonies. Let's take a listen. First, I'm gonna just make sure I didn't sing wrong. I'm gonna listen to just my two tenors. And this, remember when I was saying don't double notes? This is the opposite. I should be hearing every note be the same between these two.
Be scared, don't be scared. I'll be there, put your trust in me. And stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Victor's asking, is that pitch correction a stock plugin? Yeah, it's not even a plugin. It's a feature of the sequencer in Reason Standalone. When running not as a plugin in another DAW, you've got a mode here. If I click any audio waveform and I click pitch edit, whoop, sorry, now you're gonna hear me this way. Let me fix that. We're now gonna hear, wait, let me go here. No, wait, up here. There we go. That's better. Oh, now it went away. Okay, I'll just, if you can tolerate the reverb, if I click this and click pitch, you see a pitch representation of the audio that we've recorded in the sequencer, and we can make adjustments to it. It's standard in Reason. Okay. Jump back here. Okay, so now that one, those two tenor parts passed the mustard. Let's take a listen to the two baritone parts, the two lower parts.
Don't be scared, I'll be there, put your trust in me. And stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Great, totally acceptable double. We can live with that. So let's take a listen to all the harmonies. Let's solo just the harmonies and take a listen to those with Gavin's chorus lead. I might need to, I guess I'll turn them down a little bit. I mean, this is, here, let's do this. Let's do this the right way, right? If it's worth doing, it's worth doing right. So I'm gonna take my two tenor parts and I'm gonna group those and I'm gonna call that tenor. Then I'm gonna take my two berry parts and I'm gonna group those and I'm gonna call it berry. Then I'm gonna move berry over next to tenor. And now I've got two faders here that I can adjust and balance. So I'm gonna set up something of a loop, which I assume, well, I'm gonna make the loop that for right now. Okay, let's take a listen. I think I've got just the vocals soloed.
Don't be scared, I'll be there, put your trust in me. And stop pretending I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Guys, not so bad, right? I mean, we did it. We made vocals. Now, someone was asking, do harmonies always have to be higher or lower? They don't. Like, I could take, for example, let me pull out some of these parts. The high part. If I wanted to sing,
don't be scared.
If I wanted to sing that lower, don't be scared. I could sing that high part an octave lower, and we'd end up with this.
Don't be.
Wait, sorry. Hang on. Wait.
Be scared.
How do I, which one do I want to hear? I want to hear this. Yes.
Okay, there we go. I'll be there.
I'm going to try and do this live.
Don't be scared.
I don't know if I can. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. There it is. Don't be scared.
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
It goes too low for me. Ah, abort, abort. Okay. Yeah, Barry White. Exactly. Oh, I see what you did there, Disco Devil, with a little pun. Yeah, so you could do that though. If you, let's say that Gavin wasn't singing, don't be scared. What if it was a female vocal and we were singing it up higher? Don't be scared, like somewhere up there. You may not want to stack even female vocals. You may not want to stack above that. You may want to stack from top down. So you can make those choices. And likewise, the low part, I probably can get in a not great way, but I probably can get the low berry part to go above. Watch this. Let me see if I can do this real quick.
Don't.
What's the berry part again?
Don't be scared. I'll be there.
Don't. Oh boy, hang on. Don't be scared. Okay, yeah, it's up there. Let's see if we can do this. Don't be scared. I'll be there. I'm gonna bring in the song so I can. I'm gonna try and sing the Barry part an octave higher.
Yeah.
Whoa, boy. Don't record over things. Hang on. Okay.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending.
Whoa, that goes too high. Stop pretending. I can't get up there.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there. I'll be by your side.
Oh boy, that's really high. Let's do some liberal pitch correction on that real quick. I'm gonna squish the bejeebus out of that. Let's take a listen to that solo for a second.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending.
I fixed some notes there.
Stop pretending, I'll always be there. I'll be by your side.
Bye. I think that should technically go down. Let me see if I can get there. Oh, come on. Oh, maybe it's fine.
Be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Oh, we lost the reason window. Thank you. Thank you, Stefan. Stefan alerted me. Thank you. I forgot I switched to my main thing. Okay, it's back.
There, I'll be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay, now let's, as painful as that was, let's do it again. So I'm gonna move this. Oh, wait, I'm gonna do this. I'll move it down here. And then I'm going to double that. Okay. And then we're going to come up here and I'm going to sing it again.
With you. Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there. I'll be by your side. Cause my love for you is never ending.
Okay. These are not maybe vocal performances for the ages, but let's now just take a listen. I'm going to move this down to the other. We're going to solo these two high Barry parts.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there. I'll be by your side because my love for you is never ending.
Okay, now, hopefully, if I've done my job vaguely right, you should be noticing that if I play the low Barry, the low Barry and the high Barry, they should sound the same, just an octave apart. Let's hope.
Don't be scared out.
Wait a second. Oh, I have a tenor there. Something sounded funky. Wait, where's my other Barry? Barry. Am I missing a Barry? Oh, there's my Barry. Let me move my Barry. Barry with me. No. Terrible. Okay, here we go.
Don't be scared. I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there. I'll be by your side because my love for you is never ending.
So those two... Oh, sorry. Let me switch back here to... Where am I going? Here? That's better. So you'll notice those two parts are the same, just an octave apart. And so we can make the choice. We could either say that we want our harmony stack to be a high tenor and then an even higher baritone. That would sound like this, vaguely.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there. I'll be by your side, cause my love for you is never ending.
Or if we wanted to do same notes, we could do the lower baritone part and it would sound like this.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
And because it's pop music, we could decide to do both of those. We could decide that we actually, you know, it's not necessarily wrong if it sounds right and if you balance things correctly to do something like this.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
So those are choices you can make. But so hopefully what you, how do they all sound like? That's, yeah, exactly, Bill. That's what we've just got. We've got them all there. In fact, let's put them in with the song for a second. Let's pop Gavin's chorus fader up just a touch because he's got the lead. We definitely want to not lose the melody. So the worst thing we can do is stack so much harmony on and mix it so high that all of a sudden it just feels like a weird block. We, in this style of song, we actually want the harmony to be supportive but not equal to the melody.
Yeah. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
I think, is that correct? Let me see. I might have some panning going on. Let me just see.
Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be. Don't be scared, I'll be.
There we go. Fix my panning. Okay, let's take a listen.
Yeah, yeah. Don't be scared, I'll be there. Put your trust in me and stop pretending. I'll always be there, I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.
There you go. Okay, guys, we have set the record for our longest stream, which I'm sure is not a great thing for some people, but maybe some people, I hope you got something out of this. I'm going to, let me see, should I do one of my classic little, we'll play us out with the rest of, and Michael's song is so good, we've only listened to the first part of it, and so much of it is good, so I'm just going to kind of set us up, and we'll play out with the rest of it. But listen, so hopefully this makes sense to you guys. This is not a thing that you necessarily watch once. If you want to do this and you want to do this regularly, this may not be a thing that you watch once and then go, oh, got it. Oh, I just, you know, blip up to the scale. Got it. Perfect. Some of you might. Some of you, might have just gone like, get it. I got it. I can apply this now. Other people, you might want to go through this and watch this process. Try it. I hope people that have been trying at home to actually sing this with me when I've been doing the do 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 do, you've been singing along and finding those notes, bing bong, doing all that stuff, because goofy as it is to be singing a doorbell in front of your computer when you think you're making cool music, it's actually just such a totally simple, effective way to find that scale interval. So hopefully that is good for you guys, and like I said, I'll start playing Michael's song.
You showed me how.
Wait a second, I gotta unmute myself. Okay, there we go. Can we? Oh no, now we can't hear me that way. Wait a second. Oh man, this is gonna get more complicated. Wait, I'm going to. Bear with me. Wait, I'm gonna make one change to. Where's my voice? It's just my voice? That's my voice. Oh, okay, wait, I think I can do this. Hang on. Now, oh, look at that. I prepared in advance. I was all ready. Okay, so, the thing I was saying at the top of this is that we've been doing vocal harmony this whole time, but this is harmony arranging. This is just harmony arranging. So if you're doing string arrangements and you've got a melody of strings, or you're trying to find a complementary bass line to go along with your chords and you don't want to just follow the melody line too much, you can apply these same rules to what anything you do with harmony. These same rules will apply. And like we said, as you learn these rules, you begin to do it more intuitively. And as you do it more intuitively, you may find places where your sense of taste causes you to kind of break the the rule or move outside of the rule or know when the rule is worth breaking for a certain sonic texture that you want. So, guys, I think I don't even have much voice left in me to talk, let alone sing. I think that is it for us today. I hope you had fun today. Welcome back. I'm glad to be back. I'm glad to be back with you guys. And let's get together. Next week, we have a guest. Bryn Bliska is going to be our guest. She is a vibey, I don't use the word cat often, but she is a jazz cat, like a hip cat kind of vibey, a musician and composer who is going to be showing us some kind of cool ways to think about adding vibe to your music and chord progressions. That's next week. For now, let's enjoy Michael. Michael and Eucadian, thank you for this song. I'll see you guys next week.
I'll be by your side, 'cause my love for you is never ending.